Hello and welcome to Barbell Strength Choreographed Barbell Workout number 40. Your warm-up weight on the bar today is going to be 5 to 10 pounds. You want to err on the side of 7.5 to 10 pounds. You want a selection of plates nearby. Your heaviest weight of the day is going to be legs 1 or your squats. You're going to go 2 to 3 times heavier than your warm-up weight. You may want that weight for the chest as well. For dumbbells or plates individually, we'll be using those for chest flies today. That's going to be pretty tough, so probably somewhere between about 5 to 8 pounds, maybe 10 pounds for the chest flies. We're also going to be using one heavy weight for side lunges today. We've just got 4 minutes of that. We're going to have dumbbells for the hammer curls, again recommended weight, maybe somewhere between about 8 pounds to 15 pounds for the dumbbells with that. And shoulders, maybe 2.5 to 5 pounds. You have T raises today, so I probably wouldn't go much heavier than 8 pounds. We do have cleaner presses in the warm-up. If you don't want to do a cleaner press, just modify with that dead row. And I will show you an example for that in a little inset below from all of our previous warm-ups. Take the bar overhead, using the legs, keeping the bar in the line of vision. As you come down, you want to rotate the wrist at shoulder height and keep the chest up as you graze the bar down the body. If you have a shoulder impingement or you get too windy with those cleaner presses or power presses, your modification is just a dead row. All right, team. If you are ready to get going, let's go ahead. We're gonna pick up that bar. Overhand grip, your hand placement, thumb width from the outside of the thigh. Core engaged, chest up, heels down, knees soft, and let's begin. All right, we begin with a deadlift. We're gonna take it down the legs. Down three, up one, take it three, two, one, drive on up. So again, your legs are almost straight. Just a little bend in the knees, we'll activate the hamstrings. Now we're gonna reverse that tempo, down one, up three, take it down and up. You're squeezing the shoulder blades together to maintain a long, strong spine. Head in alignment with the spine. Now from here, dead row, knees and belly. Down, pull, in and up. Now you wanna connect that bar to the rib cage every single time. You got it. Now, can it be a triple row? Pull back the three. Here is three, here is two. Here is one, rise on up. You can hear that music building. Get ready, we're about to take it overhead with a cleaner press. Ready, right here, and we take it, sit. And drive, sit, and release. Using the legs to drive that bar overhead. That's it. Now power press, level up. Stay up for three presses in a row. Down, take it right back up again. Keeping that chest up as that bar comes down. Take it down, roll the shoulders. Upright row, up three, up. Bar raises the body. Elbows up in line with the shoulders. Up one, down three. Again, you want to keep the core engaged to help keep that upper body nice and quiet. We're going to go into a hand clean only. No overhead press. Come under the bar. You sit and release. Now, as that bar pushes you down, I want you to brace the abs as hard as you can so that we're working to support and stabilize the back. Now, again, as the bar comes down, pushes you into a squat, I want you to sit back in the heels, rotating the wrist at shoulder height. Now get ready, into a dead row, but knees to chest, knees to a high row. Again, we take it knees, chest, you feel the difference? Hitting the mid-fibers of the lats with that high row. Music's building again. Ready, clean and press, sit. Drive, sit, release. That's it. Try not to follow the bar down with your upper body, right? level up, have a rest of three. Stay up for three, take two, take it down, take it right back up again. All right, team, get ready. We're gonna take it into your squats. Take it down, take it right back up on the meaty part of the upper back. Squat position, down for three, two, one, and drive. Now, let's go ahead and sit back in those heels. That's it. You want to be able to wiggle the toes at the base of that movement. Lovely. Down, one, up, three, down. Now you want to keep the elbows over the hands to help you keep that chest lifted. All right, I feel the need for speed. Get ready. Single squats right here, take it down up. There you go. Every single squat counts. We're gonna prepare you for a big squat track today. Now, a little tempo change, watch this. Down and halfway up, down and all the way up. And again, make sure you've got enough room behind you. We're gonna take the right leg back and prepare for static lunges. Ready? Right leg back, down up. The back knee is searching for the floor. Driving as hard as you can into right heel. Now listen up. Step on in and change legs. That's it. Now try to keep that chest up. Avoid collapsing over that front leg. Got it. How far can you take that knee to the floor? Prepare for biceps. Step in, take a bar up, down, underhand grip, and two-two, curl up, and down to the thighs. You got it. Are you ready to pump it up? Single curls, take it up, down. Again, we're trying to keep upper body quiet to isolate the biceps. Four, in three, in two, take it down, roll the shoulders. Nice start. Okay, carefully put that bar down. We are getting ready for legs one, squats. Let's go ahead and maybe put 2 to 3 times your warm-up weight on the bar, and let me explain to you what's coming up. In barbell strength number 39, you saw front-loaded squats. There won't be any of those this time. Standard squats with the weight loaded on the meaty part of the upper back. Now, we will be doing a series of deadlifts in the second track. Now, watch this. Overhand grip. We're gonna start off with standard Romanian deadlifts, okay? We did that in the warm-up. A staggered deadlift, we're gonna take one heel up and back, and that's a precursor to a single leg deadlift, which we typically don't do in this class. That's your staggered deadlift. A sumo deadlift, one hand under, one hand over. We're gonna take the legs wide, keeping that chest up. So if you have your device in front of a mirror, you wanna be looking at your reflection in the mirror. From there, we're gonna go ahead, keeping the legs wide, and we're gonna take that straight into a sumo squat so you feel the difference. Team, this is 7 minutes with no break. Do you think you can do it? All right, let's go ahead. Load that bar up onto the meaty part of the upper back. If you need to switch out to plates or dumbbells, right here. All right, let's do this. All right, come with me, super slow. Count down for four, down. Down for three, up for one, take it down. Two, three. Now use this as an opportunity to find your range. How deep can you squat today? Now remember to engage that core as we talked about in warm-up. Now get ready. Working in the lower range, we're gonna go down and halfway up for three. Down and halfway up. Down and halfway up. Now all the way up. Let's do that again. There's your build. Get ready, team. We're about to go for liftoff. Single squats. Take it down up. Boom. not be off the curb. Got it. We're gonna turn up that intensity just a little bit more. Listen up. Down and halfway up. Down and all the way up. Do you feel the difference when we commit that range of movement? Now listen up, we're going back to the top. Smooth it out. Down, three, up, one. I want you to feel the music in the muscle. Chest stays up. Time under tension. Slow, count down for four. Just rush. Stay with me. And again. Now listen, down two, up two. Cut it in half. Avoid locking out the joint, right? Keep that pressure building in the muscle. We're going back to that lower range. Now we've got seven in the lower range. Here it comes, down and halfway up. Here is six. Here is five. I know it bites, right? Here is three. The music's building. Get ready to hit that gas pedal. Singles, down up. Everything you got. Now, can you bend that floor in half as you drive hard through the heels to drive back up, down and drive. Now, if you've got the right weight, it's getting harder and harder to stay to the beat, right? Good for you. Listen up. Down and halfway up. Down and all the way up. And again. Down and half. You got it. Before we move on to our deadlifts, time and attention. Count down slowly for four. Down. Use it, use it, use it. Go back away from that feeling. Get ready for a Romanian deadlift. Let's go ahead. Take that bar up. Take it down the legs for three. Take it three. And bring it up. All right, squeeze those shoulder blades together again. Down to the point of maximum tension. No further. Down one, up three. You got it. Back is vulnerable. In this position, again, you want to stay from the navel into the spine. Now, take one leg back. Down two, two. So here is your staggered deadlift. All right. Your precursor to a single leg deadlift. Ready, change the sides. Other side here. Down. Oh, a little bit more aggressive, right? Two more. Then we're going into a sumo deadlift. One hand under, one hand over. Legs go wide. Down two. Can you start to bring that bar down towards the floor? Drive the heels, lateral edge of the foot, squeezing the thighs together to rise. Down three. Try not to tip forward, right? Keep looking at that mirror ahead of you if you have one. That's not easy. Down one, up three, down. You feel the medials light up. Now we're going to keep the legs wide, and we're going to take that bar up onto the meaty part of the upper back. Slow sumo squat, like this. Down, squat for four. You got it. Feel the difference between the deadlift and the squat. It's subtle, but it's there. You're going to do this with it, do you? Singles, go. Down, up. So, same as before, we're driving through heels, little element of adding the outer edge of the foot. As I come down, alternate the heels up, down right heel up, and left heel, and right heel. You got it. Seconds to go, hang with me. Both heels down, slow, count down for four.
spider, blocking out all the
noises.
I could replace you, but I would
step
change
together.
It's a pointless.
Well done. Safely, clean and press that heavy bar up, overhead, and release it down. Chest. For the bench presses, if you're feeling strong today, you can keep that leg squat weight on. Otherwise, back it off by one third. So select a challenging weight, somewhere between your warm-up and your squat weight. For your flies, I'm gonna recommend between 5 to about 10 pound plates or dumbbells. Let me show you how this is gonna be broken down. This is how you want your space set up. I have plates, or you can have dumbbells by the side of the bench, ready for a fast transition. Now, let me show you the chorus with the bench press, because it's chaotic, but that was the goal, to create muscle chaos and confusion. Underhand grip to bring that bar onto the hips. Hands out to the plates, start and end point is your sternum. Avoid locking out the elbows at the top. Watch the chorus. 3 singles, followed by a stagger, halfway up, all the way up. That puts us in reverse, 3 singles down and up, and then we stagger down, halfway down, all the way down. Let me show you the isometric hold with the plates. If you don't want to do those, then you can go ahead and use both arms. You don't have to do the iso hold. It's very fast, so you have to be ready to go. We've only got 4 on each side. Look how one arm holds out to the side while the other arm moves for a full range of movement. And then after 4 of those, we're going to attempt to take that arm that was holding in the iso into a full range of movement. And that's where you're gonna feel the difference. All right, team, let's come on back. Hands out to the plates, lie back, and let's get ready to work. All right, up 2, take it up, 2 and down to stern. Take it up, avoid locking out the elbows. Now up 3, down 1, take it 3, 2, 1, drop. That's it. So far so good, right? Just wait. All right, listen up, hold it down. 3 singles, up, down, and up, down. Now you stagger, halfway up, 3 singles, down and up. Got it. Then we stagger down, and 3 singles, up and down. Avoid locking out at the top, as you stagger up, 3 singles, down and up. That's it. Stagger down. Now from the top, smooth it out. Up to 3. Up. 2, 3. Take it down. Again, that end point is your sternum. Bringing the elbows in line with the bench at the base. Now listen up. Halfway up and down. Halfway up and down. Keep that pressure on. You want to feel that difference, that limited range of movement. Got it. Get ready. Safety. 3 singles. Up, down, go. Take it 3. Take it 2. Now stagger up. 3 singles. Down, up. Down, up. Beautiful. Stagger down. I told you it's chaotic, right? 3 singles. Take it up, down. Stagger up. You feel that muscle getting tired? 3 singles, down and up, that's the goal. Muscle chaos and confusion. Stagger down, wait. Wait, wait, wait. Ready? 3 singles, take it up, down. Good job. Stagger up. 3 singles, down and up. Get ready for a fast transition. Iso hold with the plate. Ready, bring it down, sit on up. One hand holds out to the side, other hand raises. Up 3, down 1, 3, 2. Now the arm that's holding is going to start to hurt. You can bend the elbow a little bit more if you like. Now we're going to take both arms up 3, down 1, up 3. Oh, do you feel the difference in that arm that's holding steady? Tough, right? Now single, slow and heavy is up. Down. The longer the lever, the harder it is. So get crushed, you can bend the elbows a little bit more and let the biceps assist. Little tempo, range change, halfway up and down. All the way up and down. Let's do that again, halfway up, then all the way up. Super. Now get ready, we're doing the isometric hop on the other side. Are you ready to switch arms? Iso hop, one arm hop, one arm hop. Three, two. So my arm is turning away from the screen, is holding steady. It is parallel to the floor. And it's shaking, as I'm sure yours is too. Both arms are free, downward is three. Two, up, and drop. Good job. Now, time under tension, slow down, count up for four. Three, two, and slow down four. Back to the chorus. Ready? Hit it. It's up. You squeeze. Do you see I have a little hesitation at the top of each thigh? I want to connect, engage, and activate the pecs. Listen up. Down and halfway up. Now all the way up. Let's do that again. A half range and a full range. Two more times. You're almost there. I know you're just screaming, right? Mine too. Listen up. Time under tension. Rise up slowly. Counts up. Slow down. Hold right there and breathe in. So how did you do with that? So again, if you come back and do this video again, think about, could you have gone heavier with the bench presses? Did you go too heavy with the flies? Do you need to lighten up? So keep that in mind for the next one. We are ready to move on to the back. Not as many cleaner presses, but lots of rows, lots of hang cleans. We do have some cleaner presses and power presses. Weight recommendation on the bar, I would say somewhere between 7.5 to about 15 pounds on each side. If it's your first time doing this, always err on the side of caution and go to your normal back weight, and then you can take it from there. What I normally recommend for the back is to go back to your warm-up weight and maybe add about 1/4 to 1/2. Now, the cleaner press, let me just go over this for safety again. The cleaner press, you come under the bar, keeping the bar close to the body. As that bar pushes you down, you're going to use the power of the legs to drive that bar overhead, keeping it in your line of vision. As you come down, you rotate your wrist to shoulder height, keeping the bar close to the body. Chest stays up as the bar comes down. No throwing that bar away. If you cannot or do not want to do cleaner presses, not a problem. You come down into a dead row for your modification. In the warm-up, I introduced a high row. Your normal dead row, right here. Knees, belly, knees, rise. The high row, knees, chest, knees, rise. Okay, so when we go into that high row, that hits the mid-fibers of the lats. Are you guys ready for this? Let's begin. Overhand grip. Hand placement, thumb width from the outside of the thighs. Knees soft, heels down, core engaged, shoulder blades squeeze up, back, and down. Maintain that lengthened spine, head stays in alignment with the spine. Let's take it into a dead row. Knees, belly, knees, rise. I'll be there for you. I promise. Triple row, pull back the three in a row. Now you're driving the elbows to the back of the room. Rise on up. Let's do that again. Can you connect the bar to the rib cage every single row? Yes, let's pull back for 7 in a row. We're keeping that pressure on. 6 and 5. Hang on, don't put it down yet, not yet. Now we're going into a hang clean only. No press. Stand up, hang clean. 6. So let's go over this again, because now the bar is heavier. As that bar pushes you down, I want you to brace the abs. The abs are working to protect the lower back. Now sit back into the heels As you come down into that squat, chest stays up, bar stays close to the body. There's your build. Get ready, into a clean and press. Take it up now, take it sit. Drive, sit, right back up. Use the legs to drive back the bar overhead. Back to the triple dead row. To the knees, triple row. Down, three. All right, back, start to feel it. Rise on up. That's it. But every single row, very precise. Rise up, pull back for seven. In, here's the seven. That's it. Muscles start to get tired. Try not to back away from that feeling. We're going back into a hand clean only. Rise up, come under the bar, and stay down. Muscles working, trapezius. That's it. You sit. Try not to follow the bar down, right? Now imagine you're wearing a corset, pulling that abs in tight. You got it. Here's it starting to build. Now you know what that means. We're going overhead, just a little longer this time. Ready? Clean and press. Sit. Drive. Sit. Release. That's it. And again. Now what we're going to do is level up. Press, stay up, breathe, in two, and take it down, right back up again. Now, a slow, dead row, to the knees, slow, knees, belly, knees, rise up, and again. All right, we're going back to single time dead row. Ready? Here we go. Back to changing. Super. So the bar, coming to the belly. I know those muscles are getting tired. Be brave, right? Into a triple row. Back to three. Here is three. Here is two. And rise on up. All right. Now what we're doing is going to go back to a single row where the bar comes up to the chest. Knees and chest, and knees and thighs. Again, in, you feel the difference? It's subtle but pretty aggressive, right? I know. Listen up, triple high row. Pull back to three, there's that music building. So you need to start to prepare, rise up. Mind is strong, you're gonna want it. We're about to go overhead again. Ready? Clean and press. Sit, boom. Drive. And again. That's it. It is power, right? Speed and strength combined. Reset, hold it. Single dead row to the belly. You got it. And you give me a little hesitation, right at the top there. Make sure you engage the muscle. Triple low row. Pull back to three. In two. Rise on up. Let's do that again. Now we're going to go back to a single row. But the bar comes up to the chest. Knees and chest. Knees and rise up. Again. You got it. I can feel that heartbeat, that's for sure. Triple high row. Go back to three. All right, we're almost there, but we've got just a little spin. Rise up, triple again. Get ready for clean and press. Stay strong. Rise, clean and press, and fill it in. Drive. And again. Good job. I know you want to put that weight down, but remember your why. Push through, power press, level up, stay up. Last seven, six, hang on. Breathe out on the exhale. Breathe out. Breathe out. Go to the bar, and made it. Well done. Let's bend the knees, put that bar down. Good job. Are you doing okay? Now it's a good opportunity to have a glass of water, and we're gonna prepare for quite a beastly tricep track, 6 minutes at least. Let's go ahead and adjust the bar. If you're using the bar, I'm gonna recommend between about 5 to about 12, 15 pounds. Possibly not as heavy as 15, because we do have some singles, okay? We're gonna be doing tricep extensions, tricep presses. I'll tell you more about that in a moment. Go ahead, have a drink, and make those adjustments to your weights. Here is the setup for triceps. So again, you don't want to use the bar if you have any kind of wrist to elbow injury where you're uncomfortable in that fixed position. Absolutely go ahead and switch to plates or dumbbells. Remember what we said in barbell 39, you're in a skinny hallway with big brick walls pinning you to the bench. That means there's no room for those elbows to flare out, okay? Secondly, we want to keep that wrist nice and strong. If you bend at the wrist like that, it's going to start to get uncomfortable. Let's see if we can maintain a nice, flat, strong wrist. If you want, you can take the thumb from under the bar and put it on top of the bar. Now, one thing we're adding in today is a lat pull over. All right. Now, lat pullover is always done slowly. We're going to incorporate the abs, the lats, and the triceps. Underhand grip, place it on the hips. Now, please watch me before we try one together. Watch what happens to my lower back. As I take the bar back, do you see how it pulls my lower back off the bench? Now, we want to avoid that. So what I'm going to ask you to do, come with me, is tilt that pelvis up, press the back into the bench. Now, as the bar comes back slowly, do you see how it wants to pull the back up? Keep pressing the back into the bench. And then again, tilt the pelvis, engage the abs, the lats, and then the triceps. 4, 3, 2, 1. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, let's get ready for triceps. Hands up, wrists, elbows directly above the shoulders, wrists are strong, let's begin. We're gonna come back for 3, up for 1, down, 2, 3. So let's have a little look at our elbow alignment. Keep tucked in, right? Down, 1, up, 3. Down. Now you're squeezing into the back of the upper arm to initiate the lifting of that bar. Good job. So far, so good. Smooth it out. Down, 2, up, 2. Down, 2, and drive. So imagine holding a ball between the elbows. And you don't want that to stop out, right? Get ready. We're gonna go up to speed here. Singles now, take it down up. Now if that weight is too heavy and you don't have time to adjust, you can slow the tempo down to 2 down and 2 up if you must. Listen up, halfway down and up, all the way down and up. And again, so it's 1 half. And 1 full, 2 more times. Feel that difference with that limited range. Smooth it out from the top down to 3 or 4. There you go. Again, I want you to feel the difference as we slow it down. Very nice. Listen up. Down 1, up 3. Now we change the tempo in order to put emphasis on different types of contraction. Get ready, we're about to pick up the pace again. Singles down and up, down up, boom. So we want to keep that bar under full control, even if it means slowing down and leaving the feet behind. Get ready for a lat pullover. Tilt the pelvis up, slow back. 2, now. Feel the pelvis, abs, lats, and triceps engage. Surprisingly hard, right? You would think that those lats would offer a lot of assistance, but those triceps are pretty much burnt out. So this one is super tough. If it's too hard, just do a slow tricep extension. Now back to the forehead, tricep extension, singles, go. Take it down up. Ooh. All right, so this is the third time we're hitting that muscle, right? It's definitely starting to get fatigued. Stay strong, we're gonna move on in just a second. Halfway down and up, all the way down and up. And again. Just two more, and then we're gonna prepare for a tricep press. Now hold it up, and put the bar down to the ribs. Take it three, two. So bend that skinny wall way, remember? Rib wall, either side of the bench. We're pushing the arms in tight. Down one, up to three. That's it. Have you got strong wrists? Now, belt through the arms to the rib cage. Get ready to hit that gas pedal and singles. Down. So again, we are using that three-headed muscle in the back of the upper arm. So you're squeezing into the back of the arm to lift that bar up. Swimming down, down to three, up to one, down. Two, three, drive it up. That's it. You can bring that bar as close to the rib cage as you can. Now, down and halfway up. Down and halfway up. You got it. All the way up. Single press. Let's go. Four into movement. That's it. Let that knee move you through every single rep. Playing with that tempo again. One half and one full. Right here. Down and halfway up. Down and all the way up. Okay. You got it. Two more. Now we're going to revisit that lateral over. Tilt that pelvis up and slowly take it more. Three, two, and again, tilt that pelvis. Engage the lats and the tricep. I know, that's a lot going on, right? Back to the fifth K. Single tricep press, full range. Down. There you go. Hanging on tight. Down up. Little range change. You know it. Down and halfway up. Down and all the way up. And again. Oh my. Two more times. Take it down and half. One more. Now slowing it down. Slow down for four. Because I've got to bleed out every note. Let's sit on up. Underhand grip. And take that bar. Yes, I am the type that squeezes every little inch out of that toothpaste holder. Get ready for biceps. We're gonna use the bar and plates or dumbbells. Recommended weight is the same weight that you use for triceps. Go ahead, have a drink, get your weights ready, and let's talk about what's coming up. Today, the bar work is gonna be super challenging. We're gonna use three different grips on the bar today. So if you have any kind of joint injury, you might want to just use plates or dumbbells instead of the bar for the first song. We are gonna be starting with a neutral grip, all right? So the elbows are close to the waist, elbows a little bit in front of the rib cage, your standard neutral grip, what feels right for you. The second grip, we take hands out to the plates. Now there's only two heads in the bicep. This is using the inside or the shorter head of the bicep. That's the muscle that's closest to the chest. The third one is a beast, and I haven't done this one for, I think, for a couple of years, is a narrow grip bicep curl. So what we're gonna do is try and bring the hands as close together as they can. If you're super advanced, maybe you can have the pinkies touching. What's gonna happen is you're gonna get to about here and get stuck. You have one or two options. You can either lean forward a little bit in the upper body to get past that inertia, or just return the hands to neutral. The second song, you might be able to go a little bit heavier. We have hammer curls. This is the chorus. Two hammer curls, palms facing in, halfway up and hold. Three, two, one, drop. And that's it. All right, so if you're using a bar, make sure you have your standard weight on there, underhand grip, elbows close, and a little bit in front. Remember, if you start to dig the elbows into the body, that's cheating. Are you guys ready? Let's give it a whirl. All right, let's get ready for single bicep curls. 5, 6, 7, feet of shoulders, thighs. There you go. Now you know the deal, full range of movement, right? We want to take that bar all the way down to the thighs for that hardest part of the curl, the initiation. Up, breathe, downward, take in 3, 2, up and drop down. Pull the abs in tight. Keep that upper body strong and quiet. All right, here comes the first change. Hold the bar down, take the hands out to the plate. That's right, up 2, take it up, 2, and down. So see how that feels for you, right? If it doesn't feel good, take your hands back to neutral. Are you ready? Single, curl, we take it up, down. Good job. So that's going to feel a little unusual if you're just accustomed to a standard bicep curl, right? You got it. Tempo change. Up, 3, down 1. 3, 2. Ooh, even harder once you slow it down. So like I said, this is the shorter or the inside head of the bicep. You got it. Wait, wait, hang on. You can always go back to neutral at any time. You can always switch to plates or dumbbells if you wish. All right. Here it comes. This is the hardest one. This is the beast. Take it down. Hands come narrow. The closer, the harder it is. Up the 2. Down the 2. Ooh. If you find it gets stuck, you can lean forward a little bit if you need. Singles. Now go. Now this is the outside head or locked head of the bicep. This is the exercise that bodybuilders love, right? You are going to see fast results with an arm grip, bicep curl. But my goodness, you've got to earn it. That is hard. Anytime you want to go to neutral, take that option. 4, 3, get ready to put the bar down, picking up your dumbbells. Twisted curl. Here we go. Ready, up, 3, down, 1, 3, 2, twist and control it down. Rotating fingers into the shoulders. Ready, up, 1, down, 3, up, control it down. That's it. Now, chorus is coming up. 2 hammer curls, palms in, and a halfway hold. Like this. 2 hammers. Halfway hold. 3, 2, 1. Drop it down. Shoulders, thighs. Halfway hold. And again. Up, down. Halfway hold. That's an isometric contraction. We've got every type of contraction taking place in this track today. Twist and curl up. 3, down, 1, up, squeeze harder at the top, trying to get a little extra contraction as you rotate, get that pump to the bicep, got it, up, 1, down, 3, up, control it down, do you hate me, not yet, and again, alright, get ready for a bite, see if you can hold on to this. Isep hold, halfway up and hold. Hold. Try not to dig the elbows into the waist. Wow, right? Muscle is working and now changing leg. Don't give. Now follow my hands. Palms turn up. Palms turn down. Turn them up. Turn them down. Turn them up. I know, I know. Turn it. Slowly down. 2 hammers, halfway hold, take it up. Halfway hold. 3, 2, take it down and again. Halfway hold. And again, hang on, you're almost there. Halfway hold. And again, super. halfway hold. And take it down. Oh my goodness, how your biceps feel after that. Let's go ahead and put the weights down. Now I know you did 7 minutes of squats and deadlifts already, but we are now going into a series of lunges. The first one, we're going to be working on the transverse plane. In fact, we're going to be working on the transverse plane with both of them, but changing directions. Let me explain. You'll see I've got one heavy dumbbell. The first track, we're going to take the legs wide, and we're going to take the toes forward to prevent overloading the knee. Here's all we're doing. Three side lunges, center to reset with a deep sumo squat before we take it to the other side. Now look, I'm not going down and popping up. I'm not doing that. What I'm doing is I'm going deeper, deeper, deeper. So I'm pushing all my weight into the heel and lateral edge of the foot until you feel the ignition in the medials. Okay, that one is tough. The chorus, we will rotate, drop the back knee, rise up, center, turn, drop, drive, center. So if you want to use a heavy dumbbell, this is how it's gonna look, okay? The second one, I'm just putting the dumbbell down as I explain it. We have four front lunges and four back lunges, and we're gonna add a rotation. So let me show you a point of view. We go front, keeping the upper body like a train on the tracks that stays forward, but with the dumbbell, we're gonna rotate it round, so we're creating maximum instability. So if you do this even without a weight, now I'm going to put all your weight into that front heel. The opposing muscle groups are now gonna fire up to try and keep you stable. So it's gonna look like this, with or without the weight. Four lunge rotations, followed by four rear rotations. So again, you can choose to do that with or without weight. If the rotation makes you feel funky, just hold the weight center. If you can't do lunges, just go ahead and do it without. Just go ahead and do squats. All right, so I'm gonna pick up my weight and put it down at some point to cue you or coach you, but you keep hold of yours as long as you can. Legs wide, toes forward. To your right, three lunges. Go lower, lower. Center with a sumo. How low can you go? To your left. Two. Center sumo. Now one each way. One lunge and one squat. How low can you go? That's it. So we're driving into the heels to engage the medials, engage the glutes. Now it gets a little harder. Stay down for seven. Down. So it's like a mine going down the stairs. Deeper. You want to crush that floor. As if you want to put a dent into the floorboards, right? Center with a sumo to the other side. You try. How hard do you have to push before you start to feel that little pinch, right? That little bite. It's not comfortable. Listen up. Center sumo, now rotate and drop the back knee. Rotate, drop, drive, other side, down. You are searching for the floor with that back knee. And again, back to a side squat, triple lunge, down, down. Sumo center, how low can you go? Now don't cheat yourself, right? We're looking for that range of movement. Take it down, one of each, one right, one center, one to the left, one center. Let's do that again. Well done. All right, now we're coming downstairs, right? We got the seven lunges. How low can you go? Drive. So you don't feel it, right? You can take your legs a little wider or pick up a heavier load. Down. Super, super. Back to center with a sumo. Let's do seven to your left. You drive. Go for that bite, right? Get that dancer's indentation. Feel what that. Down, lower, lower, lower. Back to center, sumo. Rotational lunge. Turn and drop that back knee. Back to center, rotate. Good job. And again. All right. Let's wrap this one up neatly. One side lunge to your right. One swing up to your left. All right, let's get ready. With or without a bench, we're gonna take it into four lunges. On the front, like this. Lunge, rotate, and again. Now further weight, step from the bench. The harder you're gonna have to grind into that front heel. That's what you want. Now take that same leg, lunge it back. Back, rotate. You are still looking for a depth or range of movement, right? So that back seat is coming down towards the floor. Now, one front lunge, one rear lunge here. Front. Now take that same leg back. That rotation is always to the outside. Up. Are you keeping that upper body nice and straight, right? Firing up your obliques. You have to try extra hard into that heel to maintain stability. And again, up. Beautiful. Now we're gonna go ahead, switch to the other leg. Four front lunges, other leg. Front. Now, one side is gonna be way more dominant than the other. It depends if you're left or right-handed, right? How low can you go? Find your mojo. Same leg, rear lunge, rotate for four. Back, down. There we go. So again, it's that rotation. Doesn't feel good for you, just simply eliminate, right? You're gonna hold that weight in front. One of each. One lunge forward, one lunge back. Now that same leg goes back. Back, rotate. And again, take it up. Search to the floor with that back knee. You got it. Again, up, drive. Now what we're gonna do, is taking it into a good morning. All right, and slow. We're gonna bring that dumbbell under the chin, like this. Under the chin, now come down slowly. Two, three, four. Now, this hinge movement, we're working the hamstrings, glutes, muscles of the lower back. You take it down till you feel maximum tension in that hamstring. This is advanced, right? Back stays long and strong. If it doesn't work for you, just do a slow squat. Back to a front and rear lunge. Ready? Leg closest to me. Take it up, down. Same leg goes back. Now, switch leg. Other leg goes forward and back. There you go. Take it back. Let's switch the legs again. One front, one back. How low can you go? That is your pull, right? That comes with confidence. And again, take it up and take it back. And step together. Well done. How did you get on with that one? There was a lot going on, right? Let's prepare for our delts, working the shoulders. Recommended weight, I would say somewhere between 2.5, probably not much more than 8 pounds. Let me explain why. First part's easy. Front raise to the shoulders, upright row. Now we've already worked those traps with all those clean presses. However, for the T, we're gonna bring the arms up, back and in. Straighter arm is harder. If you need to bend the elbows, you can. If that's too much, either come to an upright row or into a rear press. Those are tough. The angel, we will take a split stance and keep under control as you lower the weights. This will be followed by a rear delt fly, like a bird flying, like a bird's wings. Followed by rising up, lateral rotation in and down. All right, so go ahead, pick up your weapon of choice. Again, if you can't take that weight overhead, take that upright row or take a rear press. Let's do it. All right, watch this. Looks like this. One front raise, one upright. Ready? It's up. Upright. There we go. Shoulder height, raise the core, and keep the weight close to the body. Elbow, shoulder height. All right, now listen up. Here comes the bite. Rise it up. Take it back right here. There you go. Squeeze and hesitate as you press back. Boom. I know that was hard. Take it down. One foot back. Angel, come up slowly. Count for four. Three. Two. Take it down. Control. Control. Again. We're going to take it back to a set stance. One front raise. One upright row. Ready? There you go. Upright. Get down. Bring it up. Okay, take it up. Try not to sway, right? Try not to use momentum. Here it comes again. Get ready. Take it up. Take it back. Oh, that is getting real heavy, real fast. Feel the delts ignite. Yes. All right, take it down. One heel up and back. Angel's row. Take it four. Take it down. Take it four. Stay in full control. I know you're tired. Now there's no more of those T raises. Just a front raise with an upright row. Relax. Take it and up. And in. Three. Two more. All right, get ready. Moving on. Rear delt glide. Hold it. All right, bend at the hips. Up two, down two. Two singles here. That's it. Smooth it out. Two twos. Pull the abs in as tight as you can. Back is long and strong. Smooth it out. Two twos. Head stays in line with the spine and two singles. Hesitate at the top of that movement. And again, you smooth it out. All right, now what we're going to do is practice a lateral rotation. Come up slowly. Rotate. Elbows in line with the shoulder again. Bring it down. Take it side. Have you got it? We're going to pick up the pace. Up to speed. Hit it. There you go. And again. Super. Hang on. Get through just one more round from the top. Rear down by two, two. Two singles. Smooth it out again. Take it up two. And two singles. Smooth it out. Control, engage, hesitate at the top. Try not to rush out. I know it's uncomfortable. Now we're going to go back to that lateral raise with a rotation up to speed. Five, six, seven. Take it in. Up, in, down. Tequila to forget. Take it in. Now what we're going to do for the last two is add two overhead presses. It's coming up now. Now, press up twice. Yeah. Take it down and in. One more time, take it out, press up twice, take it down and in. Good job, how did you get on with that? It is time for the final muscle group. We're about to wet the abs. So this ab track is a little chaotic. So let's have a look at what's coming up. First of all, is a V up. Now with a V up, it's like this. You can go as high or as low as you like. If you're uncomfortable with that, just keep the feet down. A hollow hold is exactly as it sounds. We're going to hollow out the body like a boat and hold right there. The meat and potatoes is elbow, knee, touch the toe. Elbow, knee, touch the toe. I'm not so much worried about the legs, but I want you to peel that shoulder blade off the floor. The second song, you're going to come into a sideline position, all the way in the elbow, top leg is over, toe lightly presses down. A legal cheek pushes as hard as you can into the elbow, decreasing the distance between the rib and the hip. Now the rest is side planks, but all can be done in a half plank. So in a side plank position, we've got hip drops. If that's too hard, keep the knee down, or put both hands in front as you gain your strength. Next is a gladiator up here. There's your full plank. You can drop the knees, do it here, or you can place the hands in front and bring the knees in towards the arm. The last one is a rotation. Again, full plank, or take it down to the knees right here. All right, and that's pretty much all it is. So if you guys are ready to wrap it up, let's get ready for our V-ups. Let's come up slowly. How high can you go? You're gonna wobble a lot, right? Take it up for four. Down for four. Full control. Now we're gonna do that elbow, knee, and touch the toe. We take it elbow and touch. There we go. So it's about peeling that shoulder blade off the floor. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How high can you lift the upper body? Take it 1, 2, 3, 4. Get ready. Back to a V up. Up 2, down 2. Take it up. Up and down. You choose your range. That's it. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. All right, now here's that hollow hold. Take it up and hold. Hold. Can you go higher? Higher hold. I know, I feel it too. Higher. On the other leg, elbow knee, touch the toe. We take it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Cross. Shoulder blade, peeling off the floor. Try to keep that leg elevated if you can. Two more times, take it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Back to a hollow hold. Right here, take it up. Can you come higher? I-C-O-N-I-Q-U-E, higher. We're going back to that. Elbow knee, touch the toe. Four on each side. Listen up. Un, deux, trois. We take it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. You're almost done with this. Stay with me if you can. All right, let's go ahead. Switch sides. Elbow knee and touch the toe. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. Reach. Two more. And we're going to take it to a side lying crunch. Get ready to roll on your side, face me. Elbow down, top leg over. Toe lightly touch down, crunch up, down. So the reach will be on your hip. There we go. Reducing the distance between the rib and the hip. Now we're going up to a plank or a half plank with hip drops. Like this. Down up. Now if that is too much, just drop that bottom knee down. If it's still too much, put the hands right here. All right, get ready for a gladiator. I'm gonna show you three levels. Full plank is right here. If that's too hard, just drop that knee down. If that's too hard, hold it here. That's it. All right, back to a plank or a half plank. Rotate the arm under, take it down, and up. You got it. How far under the body can you reach? This is with the knee down, right? Now we're gonna come on our backs, and give me a crunch, up, two, down. So crunch it up, two, and down. All right, let's go ahead, turn around to the other side. Side lying crunch, elbow down. Foot over, ready for your side crunches. Use the elbow now. Take it up, down. Remember the goal. Decrease the distance right here. This is a legal cheat. We take it up, down. Now get ready. Full plank or side plank for your hip drops. Ready? Here, take it down up. There we go.
So you can always drop that knee down. Down up. Feel the obliques. Ignite. Into gladiator. Here is your fourth plank. Like this. Out. If that's too much, that bottom knee comes down. If it's still too much, you lean forward, bring that elbow in towards the arm. Half plank or full plank, reach on under right here. Take it under and up. All right, let's go ahead and get you cooled down. Good job today. Let's lie on back. We're gonna take one foot up. Flex some point, wait for the hamstring to relax. Now pull the leg in a little bit further. Just to the point of gentle tension. Let's go ahead, drop that foot down. Take hold of that thigh, pull it on in. You want to feel the release here. We did all those side lunges, right? Ignited. Take that top knee, let it fall down to the side, and hand in opposite direction. Release through the lats and obliques. All right, let's switch sides. Hamstring right here, take it up. So that hamstring's gonna go real tight, right? So just flex the point, wait for it to relax, and just pull in a little bit more. Let's drop that foot down, pull that leg on in, feel that release. Yeah. Let's go ahead, drop that knee down, kind of the opposite direction. Let's take it onto the side. You want the weight almost forward. Straight line from the ear, shoulder, hip to knee. Now press that foot as hard as you can into the hand. Yeah. Come on up. And let's cross over and just push away. All right, let's take that on the other side. Let's go ahead. Stretch out the quads. You want that straight line. Knees close together and push hard into that hand. It's over, pain is over. Let's go ahead. So anytime you want to get a hold of me, you can reach me through krushworkout.com or send me a message here through YouTube. If you enjoy the workout, please like, subscribe, hit that bell icon to be notified every time I upload a new video. We're gonna drop that shoulder down. And if you're on your fitness journey, share this video with your friends. And don't forget, send me your before and after pictures. Show me your progression. I want to see it all. Come on up. Let's go ahead. Take your hands behind. Stretch out that chest. Let's take the arms forward. Separate the shoulder blades. You did those T raises. Take one arm up. Press the head back into the triceps. Great job today, ladies and gentlemen. Don't forget to keep pushing. Take yourself a deep breath. Inhale and have yourself a fabulous day.
The more I push, the more I gain.